thanks, Julian, for your very generous words. I must say thank you for, thanks to Admiral Rickover for the extraordinary career that he had in service of America, which he, his brilliance took science and put it through his vision of what it could do and produced extraordinary results for our country, which continue on today in the nuclear submarine force that just grows in utility to our country. But he understood always how critical science was to our future, to our quality of life, not just to our security, but the effect of our prosperity and our freedom. Joanne was with him at the creation of this organization, and it is her commitment to it, her infectious commitment to it that drew me in. And I must say that as I look back at the 24 years in which I was privileged to be a U.S. Senator, and I got to do a lot of things that I feel good about, this one really is special, and I have a special pride about it, because the center really finds talent, educates it in STEM education fields, raises it up, and then honors it. And when you think about what the graduates of the CEE programs have already done for the rest of us, it just makes me feel very proud to be part of the program. And I can't thank you enough for creating this award. I will tell you that as legacy projects go, I couldn't ask for more. It's a particular honor. I was thinking as a congresswoman this week, if you'll allow me to only slightly digress about how things change. The other night, my wife and I, trying to break away from a dependency that we've developed, which is not healthy, on cable news at night. It's quite destructive since the beginning, since January. Well, I won't mention the date. So we went to one of the, might have been Netflix, I don't know, and we saw The Graduate. Oh, let's watch The Graduate, 1967. And I was thinking that famous scene where the guy meets Dustin Hoffman by the pool at the party that his family wants to take him aside and puts his arm around him. Just one word I want to mention about your future, Ben, plastics. I was thinking today, if we were doing that scene, arm around his shoulder, I want to mention about your future, Lauren, algorithms. Anyway, I am really honored to present this award and to do so not only to the recipient, but in the presence of her mom. I got a chance to meet Dr. Ansel, and I must say she reminds me of my mom in many ways. One is the absolute dispassion she has about the accomplishments of her child. I will just share briefly, I don't want to keep you, a great day of my life. It's a Monday in August of 2000. We get the call that Al Gore, the Vice President, asking me to run his running mate. So we fly family to Nashville, and he's going to announce it the next morning. And my mom gets on the plane with us. She's 85. And go into the room with the Gore's hostess, and there we go into the room. My mom looks up at Vice President Gore and says, "Mr. Vice President, you certainly made the right choice." this is one last story about my mom, you like this. I saw Larry King, believe it or not, last week. He's still on TV, and we did an interview, and he was interviewing my mother the night I got this, something we could never have imagined in our lives. And I was nominated, and he said, "I'll never forget." At one point, I said to your mother, "Mrs. Lieberman, how do you handle it when you think your son has made a mistake?" And your mother said, "Mistake?" Excuse me. My son was a big mistake. That was like, I tell Dr. Ansel that you've got a strong supporter behind you. Dr. Lauren Ansel Meyers has done extraordinary work. It happens to be, she happens to be focused, and she was a graduate of the RSA program in 1990. She's doing incredibly important work that I happen to spend some time on myself, so I'm grateful to her, and I didn't know this before. I knew she was going to get the award on both detecting and dealing with infectious disease epidemics and their unfortunate unfortunately, human-created parallels, which are bioterrorist attacks, doing some really critical work with mathematics that I think will save a lot of lives in the years ahead. I just wanted, before I present the award, to pull her up here. And she said something, which is in your program, but I just want to read it because RSI 1990 was incredibly formative. My cryptography research project, public presentation, and most of all, my brilliant Rick-like friends inspired me to become a scientist, tackling real-world challenges using advanced mathematics. And end of quote. Well, you join, and the spirit of Admiral Rickover, which fills the room, you couldn't have a greater tribute and affirmation for the extraordinary value of what you're doing. So, Dr. Meyers, this envelope was given to me not by the people who handle the Academy Awards. I am really honored to thank you for the work you presented.
Thank you so much, Senator Lieberman. I am truly, truly honored and moved to be receiving this award today. The Center for Excellence in Education, as you all learned, was founded by Heinz Rickover in 1983, and ever since led by the phenomenal Joanne Mutinero. Has fundamentally advanced science across America and has been pivotal in my own life and career. Its flagship program, the Research Science Institute, which I attended in 1990, the only year it was actually hosted by University of California, San Diego, beautiful summer. It gathers brilliant teenagers from all across the globe, and it propels them to the frontiers of science and technology. For many of my fellow Rickoids, and that's what we call ourselves, RSI was life-changing and only possible because it was free. Through it, we opened our eyes and our hearts to the joys of science, the joys of innovation, of discovery, of collaboration. And it charged us with the confidence and sense of responsibility to tackle the challenges of tomorrow. After RSI, I studied math and philosophy as an undergraduate at Harvard, and then I studied biology as a PhD student at Stanford. I have been on the faculty of the University of Texas at Austin for almost 15 years, where I used math, big data, high-performance computing to figure out the how, the when, the where, and the why of infectious disease outbreaks, like the recent epidemics of Ebola in West Africa, and the emerging threat of Zika in the Americas, and the persistent specter of pandemic influenza. I also developed new techniques, new tools for detecting outbreaks, for monitoring outbreaks, and most importantly, controlling their spread. Senator Lieberman, thank you for your inspirational support for the Center for Excellence in Education and for your distinguished service to the United States. Like so many who aspire to contribute to the great American story, I come from unlikely beginnings. As a first-generation American, I am the proud granddaughter of Holocaust survivors, Pincus and Bluma Weinstock, who are no longer with us, but would certainly be beaming today. Because of them, their remarkable kindness and gratitude for their life in America, because of my incredible parents, Esther and Frederick Ansel, who nurtured my love of math when society said otherwise, and because of RSI, where I got my first taste of using mathematics to answer, to solve hard, important, real-world problems, today I strive to be a fearless and compassionate scientist, crossing disciplines to create new methods and glean new insights, and building bridges to the front line of global health so that we can translate the very best science and data into saving lives. Thank you so much.